entrance of the forest, all of the ashes had been blown away, but the peas and lentils had taken root and shot up by the moonlight to open the way. They walked all night until at last they reached the mill, where she told her father all she had been through.
The next day was the day of the wedding, and the miller had invited all his friends and relations.
Suddenly, the robber bridegroom. And in turn,
my love, you've been so quiet. Now it is your turn to tell us a story.
I will tell you a dream I had. I dreamed I was walking in a wood, when suddenly I came to a house where there was no one about and it was dead silent. I went inside, but there was still no one. There was a birdcage on a wall, and in it, a bird would cry, turn back, thou bonny bride, nor in this house of death abide. I was only dreaming this, my love. There, I went to the cellar, and I found an old woman with a shaking head. Does my bridegroom live here? I asked her. You poor child, you know not where you are. You are in a murderer's den. Your bridegroom does indeed live here. But he will cut you to pieces, cook you, and eat you. My love, I was only dreaming this. No sooner had she hit me behind the wine cask when murderers came in, dragging behind them a maiden. They gave her 3 glasses of wine to drink, 1 red, 1 white, and 1 yellow. The maiden fell dead. One of the robbers noticed a gold ring on the girl's little finger, and since he could not get it off, he took an axe and he chopped it off. Here is the ring!
At these words, she produced the finger and showed it to the company. The robber bridegroom took the finger from her and threw it on the floor.
When the robber bridegroom heard this, he turned as pale as ashes. Oh, he tried to escape.
The death fell upon him.
And executed him on the spot.
The end.
According to Aesop, there once was a man who loved his cat very much.
Seeing this, Venus, the goddess of love, changed the cat into a beautiful woman.
Upon seeing this, he took the woman to his bedchamber.
The end.
king. Charming little pal, my dear. Who's next? Who wants to be next?
Not pass the test, you shall marry the rope maker's daughter, and the croaking of the raven
shall steal the horse from which I own, riding out of the stable. Second, he shall steal the sheet while me and my wife are asleep on it, without our observing it. Oh, also, you must steal the wedding ring off of my wife's finger. And lastly, you shall steal from out of the church the parson and the clerk. Mark what I am saying, for your life depends on it.
That night, the master thief put on the garments of an old woman, and onto his face painted the wrinkles of age. And from an old wine sack, full of Hungarian wine, he had.
Disguised as the count himself.
Husband,
caution and with pleasure. And if you do not succeed, then all of them will.
Thank you.
So saying, the flounder swam back to the sea. Then the fisherman got up and went back to his wife and her hobble.
Flop! Husband, have you caught anything today?
No, all I caught was one flounder. Well, he said he wasn't a chance to print, so I threw him back.
Did you not wish for anything?
No, what was it a wish for?
Is it bad enough for me to live in this wretched, filthy home? The least you could have wished for was a nice, clean body. He would have surely agreed to do that.
No, Bob, what am I to go back there for?
Go back and ask for a cottage. He'll give it to you.
All right, I'll go ask.
The man was still not very willing to go, but he did not want to vex his wife, and at last he went back to the sea. He found the sea no longer bright and shiny, but dull and green.
She wants to-